how to transfer music from computer to iPhone. Hello friends, welcome back to Apple Friendly, video number 58. Today I'm going to tell you everything about transferring the music from computer to iPhone using iTunes. And these are the topics I'm going to discuss today. Even if I'm showing this using computer, steps are going to remain the same for Mac users as well. So without further ado, let's get started. So let's start with the first method, that is managing the music manually. So launch the iTunes on your computer, connect iPhone and tap this little iPhone icon. Now in the summary section, select this manually manage music and videos. Now let's go back and add music to iTunes library. Always remember that before adding music to iPhone, you need to add music to iTunes library. And then only you can transfer it to your iPhone. So this step is going to be common for both the methods. So select file on the main menu bar, select add file to library. A browser window will open up. Look for the songs that you want to add to iTunes library. Select that song and tap this open button here. Now we have added the new song to iTunes library. Now to transfer it to your iPhone, just select the song and drag it over devices section on your iPhone. That's all. Now when I select the music option here, it will show my new song on my iPhone. Now I just have to sync my iPhone with iTunes. So that's how you add music to iPhone manually. The advantage of this method is you never lose your old songs from your iPhone even if you don't have them in your iTunes library. As in this case, I have only 4 songs in my iTunes library, but I've got 9 songs on my iPhone. So when I sync my iPhone with iTunes using this method, I'll not lose any of the old song from my iPhone, even if it is not there in my iTunes library, which is exactly not the case with the second method. Now let's see how the second method works. Just tap this little iPhone icon here. Now in the music section, you've got this sync music option. When you select this checkbox, it gives a pop-up warning. It says that it will replace all the songs on your iPhone with the songs in your iTunes library. Let me show you what does it exactly mean. So let me cancel it for now and let's go back to our iTunes library page. Now here, as you can see, I've got only 3 songs in my iTunes library. And if I select music option under devices section, I've got total 8 offline songs. So if I had selected sync music option earlier, iTunes would have deleted these 8 songs and replaced it with these 3 songs. I would have lost my old songs which are not there in my iTunes library. And that is why I don't prefer this method. So let's go back to iPhone and see what are the other options that we have for syncing music automatically. Here, if I select the checkbox, as we already know, it gives a warning. Still, I'll go ahead and select remove and sync for a demo purpose. And when you select, you get 2 more options beneath it. The first one is entire music library. If you keep this option selected, it will simply sync the songs from iTunes library to iPhone. As in our case, 8 songs will be replaced with 3 songs. Another option is selected playlist, artist, albums and genres. This option is useful if you want to sync only selected playlist and not the entire music library, like recently added playlist. I would suggest to keep entire music library selected in case you're using this method. So this completes the second method. No matter what method we use, we have to select sync or apply button at the bottom right hand corner of the iTunes window to transfer music to iPhone. And now iTunes is transferring music to iPhone from the computer. Now let me tell you what happens if you switch between these 2 methods. Well, if you're managing music manually and switching to automatic syncing method, you may lose your old songs from your iPhone if you don't have them in your iTunes library. On the other hand, if you're switching from automatic syncing to manually managing method, you'll not lose anything because iTunes library and iPhone music are not in sync. So now you can decide which method you want to follow to transfer music from computer to iPhone. So that's all for now. I hope you guys understood the difference between the 2 methods. And if this video helped, share it with your friends and loved ones. And if you want to see more tutorials like this, visit my website applefriendly.com. I'll see you in my next video. Till then, take good care of yourself. And as always, subscribe, stay tuned, and keep the notifications on for my next videos. Thank you for watching.